मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू ऑनलाइन क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ सरफेस टेंशन। इन द लास्ट क्लास ऑलरेडी वी हैड डिस्कस्ड व्हाट इज सरफेस टेंशन। यस नीड, द सरफेस टेंशन इज द अमाउंट ऑफ फोर्स एक्टिंग फॉर यूनिट लेंथ ऑन द सरफेस ऑफ ए लिक्विड। दिस इज ओनली इज कॉल्ड एज व्हाट, सरफेस टेंशन। What is the unit of surface tension? Newton per meter. So now let us discuss a small illustration regarding the surface tension. You take a beaker of water, you take a paper clip, you take a tissue paper and spread it on the surface of water. Gently place the paper clip on the tissue paper. Observe what happens to the paper pin after some time. After a few moments, the tissue paper will submerge. What is the meaning of submerge? Immerse. And the paper clip will make a small depression on the outer surface of the water. It will instantly begin to float on the surface, even though it is denser than water. So what happened? The paper clip is floating on the water surface. How is it possible? This is due to water molecules on the surface which tend to contract themselves like the molecules of an elastic membrane. So due to the surface tension only, the molecules are, what molecules? Water molecules are contract themselves and it is act as an elastic membrane. A force exists on them which tends to minimize the surface area of water. The paper clip is balanced by the molecules on the water surface that is now behaving like a stretched elastic membrane, so it does not submerge. So whatever may be the weight of the paper clip, it comes for the floating only, it does not comes for the immerse due to the surface tension only. So what happens here? The water molecules on the surface which tends to contract themselves. Here already you know the water consists of the water molecules, isn't it? Hydrogen and oxygen molecules only. So the molecules, it comes for the contract. Afterwards only it is minimized the surface area when the forces existed. After that only the paper clip is balanced by the molecules on the water surface that is now behaving like a stretched elastic membrane. Are you understand children? This is the example for surface tension. Now let us move on to the applications of the surface tensions. So first see the picture also. The first picture is given for the water or the raindrops, it's taken as a spherical shape. It's already discussed due to the surface tension only. So for a given volume, the surface area of the sphere is the minimum. This is the reason for the liquid drops to occur the spherical shape. So already you know the surface of the liquid begins like a stretched membrane. This is only you have to call it as an elastic membrane. The surface tension is a property of a liquid due to which tends to decrease or minimize its surface area. So afterwards only the water, the raindrops, it comes for the spherical in shape. So the given volume, the surface area of the sphere is the minimum. This is the reason for liquid drops to occur a spherical shape. And see the second figure also. Is given as a word, ship is given, is needed. So during a heavy storm, sailors pour the oil into the sea near their ships. What is the reason? It is used to decrease the surface tension of the water, sea water. So this process reduces the impact of the violent water current against the hull of ship. That's why they are using water, pouring the oil nearby the ship. This is the reason for what? Decreasing the surface tension. And third one, we have to move on to the third figure also. It's given as a water striders. It's needed. You could able to see the water strides. Yes, striders are can walk on water. It's needed. It's easily it's walking because the water strides, striders are the insects with six legs. Despite being denser than water, water striders does not sink. Instead, it exploits the principle of water tension or in the surface tension to stay on its surface. It is to distribute the weight over a greater surface area, further helping it to float. So the weight over the greater surface area, and afterwards only the strider it comes for the floating. That only we have to say the water strider insect slides on the water surface easily due to the surface tension of water. And fourth one application of the surface tension is water molecules rise up due to surface tension. Already you know, xylem tissues are very narrow vessels present in plants, isn't it? Water molecules are absorbed by the roots, and these vessels help the water to rise upward due to capillary action. So what is the meaning of capillarity action? It is a very important for moving water. That is only is called as the capillarity or in the capillary action. It is defined as the movement of water within the spaces of porous material due to the surface tension. That is, a porous means it's taken as a very very smallest holes. That is the meaning of the porous materials. So the movement of the water within the spaces of the porous materials due to the surface tension. So the water rises in the plants, and which is caused by the surface tension of water. So the water molecules are absorbed by the roots, and these vessels help the water to rise upward due to the capillarity action, which is caused by the surface tension of water. So the water rises into the roots and also in the plants also with the help of the capillarity action only. The capillarity action takes place with the help of the surface tension only. So I hope students you understand the surface tension and also the applications. So the first application is taken as what? Liquid drops are occurs the spherical shape due to the surface tension, and during a heavy storm the sailors pour oil into nearby the ships. It decreases the surface tension of the seawater. And third, the water strider, the insect slides on the water surface easily due to the surface tension of water. And fourth one, the water molecules are rise up due to the surface tension, and also the water to rise upward due to the capillarity action also, which also causes due to the surface tension. So next we got to move on to one more important concept in force as well as the pressure. See the picture also. It take a small quantity of different kinds of liquid like coconut oil, honey, water and ghee in a cup, or we have taken as a bottle. Place one drop of each liquid on a separate glass plate. Next, gently raise one end of the glass plate one by one so as to allow the liquid to slide down the smooth surface of the plate. Observe the speed of each liquid. So the each liquid moves with a different speed, isn't it? Because the four are taken as a different liquids only we are taking. One is honey, one is coconut oil, one is water, one is ghee, isn't it? So each liquid moves with a different speed. Water flows faster than other liquids. Coconut oil, it flows with a moderate speed, and ghee flows very slowly. And also the honey also, it flows very slowly only. What is the reason? Between the layers of each liquid in motion, there is a frictional force parallel to the layers of the liquid. So the frictional force is nothing but it is the opposite direction of the force only. When we are rubbing our hands, we could able to feel the heat, isn't it? Due to the frictional force only. So the frictional force is acted between the layers of each liquid. It opposes the force value or the motion also. So the frictional force parallel to the layers of the liquid, this This frictional force opposes the motion of the liquid layers while they are in motion. Compared to the water and to the coconut oil, here the frictional force is very less for water. So that's why it moves very fastly. And compared to the coconut oil and the honey, the frictional force is very large in honey. That's why it flows very slowly. So here the frictional force, it opposes the motion of the liquid layers while they are in motion. So it gives us an important quantity in physics. It's given us a viscosity of a liquid. So the viscosity, simply we have to say the state of being thick, sticky and semi-fluid in consistency due to the internal friction. This is only called as the viscous or in the viscosity, or a quantity expressing the magnitude of internal friction in a fluid measured by force by unit area resisting uniform flow. So it depends upon the internal friction values only. How much amount of the internal friction is acted between the layers of the liquid, based on this only we could able to say the viscous or in the viscosity. So the state of being thick, sticky and also the semi-fluid. Compared to the water and the honey undercomes this condition. It is taken as a honey, it looks like it's a thick, sticky and also the semi-fluid, isn't it? And also it is, the viscosity is taken as an internal friction in a fluid measured by force by unit area resisting the uniform flow. So how much amount of the force is acting between the layers and how much amount it opposes the further movement while it comes for the motion, that also is describes the viscosity or in the viscous. So it comes for the conclusion, what is viscosity? So when a liquid is flowing, there is a frictional force between the successive layers of the liquid. Already you know that liquid or in the water is described in the layers format only, isn't it? So the flowing, there is a frictional force between the successive layers of the liquid. This force, which acts in order to oppose the relative motion of the layer. Relative motion means first layer and second layer, it moves with a particular speed. It also is related to each other. That is only is called as the relative motion of the layer. It's known as viscous force. Such property of a liquid is called viscosity. So what is viscosity? Liquid flowing, there is a frictional force between the successive layers of the liquid. This force, which acts in order to oppose the relative motion of the layer, is known as viscous force. So it opposes the further movement of the liquid or in the liquid layers. This is called as viscous force. Such property of a liquid is called viscosity. So in this video, we discussed what is surface tension. And second, we discussed a small activity regarding the surface tension. And third, we discussed the applications of surface tension. And fourth, we discussed the important properties taken as a viscous force or in the viscosity. So the viscosity force is measured by the unit called poise in CGS unit. And kilogram meter power minus 1, second power minus 1, or Newton second meter power minus 2 in the SI unit. So I hope students you understand this concept, surface tension and viscosity. Thank you children.